Let's talk about that one question when it comes to upgrading. What happens if I actually choose to stay on Windows 10? So let's discuss that to give you that information that you need to make the decision. Hi, I'm Michelle, a computer coach here sharing tips and tricks on your everyday software to make life that little bit easier. If you find the information in this video helpful, please remember to like the video and give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to be notified as new videos are released every week, then remember to subscribe to the channel. What actually will happen if you choose to stay with Windows 10? So the first question is, can you stay with Windows 10? The simple answer is yes. Microsoft cannot force you to upgrade. What will happen if you choose to stay with Windows 10? Well, nothing immediately is going to happen. Your computer will still turn on, your programs will still continue to run. So everything is fine now. Obviously, Microsoft is probably going to send you lots of messages recommending that you upgrade, saying that Windows 10 is out of support. So be prepared for probably quite a few messages on screen. You may have seen that Microsoft is offering an extended security update program, the ESU. So, what's the options with that? Breaks down to consumer and business. As a consumer, there is a one-off fee, which at the time of recording is $30. However, that's for a single year extension. If you are a business, again at the time of recording, this is a subscription for 3 years. As I understand it, that's locking you in for 3 years. The first year is $61. However, it then doubles during the second and third year. So your second year is going to be $122. And of course, it's going to double after that for the third year. Is it worth it? Well, maybe if you need additional time to put that upgrade plan in place. Maybe if you are a business, you've got stuff that you still need to check, and of course, purchasing, building, rolling out, all of that stuff. So the answer is a maybe. Is it actually worth staying on Windows 10 overall? Well, if you do choose to do that, first thing to note is that there will be no new protection coming from Microsoft. So there will be no security updates. There will be nothing from them on Windows 10 at all. That means that you will be more open to cyber attacks. I'm not saying that this is going to happen, but remember, you've still got your additional cyber security. So that's things like the firewall, your antivirus, all of those bits, and you will need to make sure that either yourself or a company that you are paying to look after your computer system is on top of that, that any updates that come through are pretty much immediately applied. However, your system, because it's not receiving new updates and improvements, the system will start to slow down. Let's be honest, all of our computers feel like they slow down pretty much like the day after you've got them. However, that reduction in speed can also be in terms of your applications, and you might find that you are sitting around waiting for them when you want to be getting on with other things. Finally, updates won't run. Now, this is not only will you not receive any updates from Microsoft, but the updates for your software, that's the stuff that you use every day, will stop working at some point in the future. And in fact, you might not be able to upgrade to the latest version of your platforms, your software, because they are no longer compatible with Windows 10. It's not a long-term solution. Same with Windows 10, that's just not going to happen. And remember, at some point, your devices will become obsolete. They'll just become too old. You will need to buy a new one, and those will come pre-installed with Windows 11. As a short-term solution, the answer is maybe. If you need more time to actually put everything into place, or you've already got a plan in place, but it's going to be a longer run time than October this year, that's 2025, then that the time at which potentially moving over to either the additional support or actually just leaving them for now is going to be a more valid option. However, it's your choice what you're going to do. That is, stay on Windows 10, move over to Windows 11, or even move away from Microsoft Windows completely. Whatever you decide to do, I hope that this video has helped. And if you have any questions, I will do my best to answer them if you post them in the comments below. And I will see you on the next video.